How's it going, everybody? Welcome back. Today I'm going to show you guys how you can enable your Chrome extension, the VPN Chrome extension specifically. So of course I've picked three of the best VPNs. If you guys are interested, these vary in budget and features. It's up to you whether you want to go with one over the other. Be sure to check the full review in the description down below if you'd like to learn more about them. And you also find links to pricing discounts. So it's very simple. Just go ahead and go to one of these websites. Let's say, again, these VPNs are very good, especially if you want to unblock Netflix or just simply secure your device. So with ExpressVPN, for example, you can just go to products, pick Chrome. With NordVPN, go to download VPN and pick Chrome. With Surfshark, same thing here. You can go to VPN and pick Chrome, okay? And once you're there, just hit download app, download extension, and download extension. Now, since I already have the extension installed, I don't have the option to add it to Chrome, and you cannot add extensions in incognito. So once you hit add to Chrome, it will be added to your Chrome. Let me just go ahead and just go to extensions. There we go. I already have them all in my extensions. So yeah, that's pretty much how you can add the Chrome extensions or the VPN Chrome extensions to your Chrome browser. Okay. Now, I personally like to use the applications themselves because once you pay for the VPN subscription, you get access to the application. And if you go to the application, let's say you only want your Chrome browser to use the VPN, you can still do that with split tunneling. And all these VPNs do have split tunneling. So let's say I'm gonna do it with ExpressVPN. Go to split tunneling, activate it before you turn on the VPN. Go to settings, only allow selected apps to use the VPN. Add the Chrome browser. You can add anything you want here. And you can even add other apps. In this case, I want my Chrome browser, only my Chrome browser, to use the VPN while the rest of my connection is left outside the VPN tunnel. And so I just click OK. And once I turn on my VPN, nothing will be affected by my VPN except for my Chrome browser. So hopefully this video helped you guys out. If you guys have any more questions, feel free to post them in the comments down below. And also be sure to check the description down as well for links to pricing discounts as well as the full review. The top three VPNs video will give you all you need to know about these three VPNs. Like and subscribe if you'd like to support the channel and stay up to date with everything VPNs and cybersecurity. It'll help me out a lot. Thank you guys very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.